This is the bench I installed in my boat. So this bench is made out of some reclaimed mahogany. On the starboard and port sides, there are two mahogany boxes. They're originally going to be mahogany footlockers, and I realized I wanted a bench, and so I cut them apart and I joined them in the middle with another piece of scrap mahogany, so it made the length that I wanted. It's pretty stout. The box sides are an inch thick of mahogany, and the top, I had a remaindered piece of marine ply, 3/4 inch, and I edged that also with some remaindered mahogany, and I used the same Fidiz dye product, red mahogany, on all the surfaces, and I applied about 5 coats of varnish. You can see here some very nice dog claw marks that immediately started marring the surface, and just making it so that, you know, now it can be used. So it can't be perfect. So this is about 14 inches deep this way. It makes for a really nice seat. You can use it as a little table, and there's still a decent amount of room up in the front here toward the bow in the compartment for putting your feet, or you can also sit down there and kind of put your feet up here. And there's a decent amount of space here to the rear bench. There is a cushion here on the rear bench that I had made, that just ties onto the bench. It really makes a much more comfortable seating surface, obviously, than just sitting on the wood. And I have another one coming that will match this bench, and I'll secure that to the top of the bench. Another benefit of installing the bench in addition to seating was putting the gas tanks in a permanent location. So underneath this, there are two 6-gallon gas tanks. I'm gonna open the latch. This is just latched down with a bungee, so it opens, and I have two 6-gallon tanks that are secured in here with just some bungees that are screwed in. It's just a random top. I put a little secured a piece of wood here with a screw just to act as a little holder. This looks strange, but these are pieces of extra dense foam that are secured to the edges here. Just simple, easy to replace if need be. It's held on a little 3500. And what that does is it acts as a little bit of a cushion. They sit here on the edges and they compress, and it just provides a little bit of cushioning so that if you're, you know, in some waves or something like that and you're kind of going up and down, it cushions that just a little bit, and just enough not to be, you know, hitting just the wood. The cushion again will help with that quite a bit. Because the middle is open, you don't have to worry about venting, and you don't have to worry about, you know, a limb or anything like that. The water will just, you know, pass back and forth along the sole if there is some. And that's about it. I did obviously finish the outside. I didn't finish the inside as much because there's not really a huge need to do that. I'm not worried about wood movement or anything like that too much. You know, it's a moist environment, but for the most part, the inside of the bench is going to remain relatively dry. And even if it doesn't, it'll dry off at some point. It's pretty thick wood. It's also joined together with Festool dominos. So the joinery here between these pieces, the dry bag sitting there, is so between the original box and you know, the joining sections here, there's a joint here, and that's held together with just some Titebond 2 and also two Festool domino joint, domino floating mortises here and here, and that makes for a very, very stout joint. Also, the edges of the boxes are dominoed with very stout, large number 12 dominoes. They're not going anywhere. It's secured to the boat. Let me put this down. Snug that down. Drop it down here. And it is secured to the boat along the stanchion. Can't really see that too well because there's all kinds of stuff in the way, but right down here between the box and this is a stanchion, there's a block, and it's just two stainless steel screws that are holding it in. So it's almost shimmed in place, as well as some stainless steel fasteners. And again, it really doesn't move at all. the sole of the boat is not completely flat. And so where the edges of the bench rest on the sole, the what I guess you call it the feet or these edges are proud of the sole, and I put some rubber stoppers under there just to give it a solid surface, and also I didn't want any kind of a very hard material there, and that seems to work pretty well. Tested it out the other day and it seems to work fine, and I think once the cushion's on there it'll be quite a comfortable ride. Just secure that with a bungee, and that's about it. I'll get back here so you can kind of see how it situates. So that is the bench, and again, I'm probably going to put a, well, I will be putting a cushion once it arrives across here, and that should do it.